It makes me happy to say that today is officially the day that Mixitup has launched their YouTube integration. And I say that, but it may not be today for you, may not even be yesterday, maybe only be a couple of weeks, a couple of months, a couple of years from now. But either way, it's been in beta for a while and today it's full available for everyone out there. So whether you're already streaming on YouTube or you're planning to move from Twitch to YouTube streaming, I'm gonna show you all the differences you need to know. But best of all, it already leverages the exact same interface and experience which you know and love and Mixitup. You can keep all your rewards, you can keep all your redemptions, you can keep all your automations. But there's just a couple of important things which you need to know, which we're about to run through. So if that sounds cool, nice and nifty, like, subscribe, bell, all that kind of jazz. But as always, first thing we're going to do is we're going to open up Mixitup. And from here, you won't see YouTube by default. So what we're going to do is we're going to hit the gear up in the corner. We're going to go down to advanced and you want to make sure that update preview program is on. Now, once you've enabled that, you're going to want to just close your Mixitup and reopen it, and it'll essentially ask you for another update. Update it, and it'll take you back into Mixitup, in which you'll see some of these YouTube settings. So if we close this settings menu, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to open up the hamburger menu. We're going to go over to events, and you can see that within this, YouTube is right below Twitch. Now, very similar to Twitch, YouTube has all the popular events which you're going to need. Stream start, stream stop, new member milestone, member gifted, mass member gifted, and also the super chat. Now, I'm assuming most of you out there kind of know the differences between Twitch and YouTube, you know, the bits versus super chats and the subs versus the memberships and whatnot. But we're going to quickly talk about it because we just want to make sure that there's no confusion, because Mixitup has essentially chosen a path of how to talk about it. So whenever someone essentially follows your channel to essentially, you know when you're live, know when you're streaming, know when your new content comes out, without paying anything, just that generic kind of follow thing, Mixitup will label that as a follow. So within Twitch, that's a follow, but within YouTube, that's a sub or a subscriber. Now, whenever someone pays any money to essentially support your channel, so in Twitch's case, a subscriber, but in YouTube's case, a member, Mixitup will label that as a subscriber. Now, why this isn't really an issue within these specific YouTube events, if we quickly open up the generic events, channel follow, that will be your YouTube sub, and channel subscribed, this will be your YouTube membership. So if you are using any of these generic events, just making sure that you're using the right one. But if we quickly close this within the specific YouTube events, look, as I mentioned before, this is the same Mixitup which you know and love, all the features and functions. So if we want to do any automations for whenever someone, you know, subscribes to your channel and, you know, becomes a member, if we go add command, we essentially have the trusty old command editor which we know and love. We can add any action groups within our commands, we can send any chat messages, we can do everything you know and love. So again, if you are thinking of moving over from Twitch to YouTube, you don't necessarily have to rebuild all your automations. You can just, you know, make sure you're part of this preview program, update it, and then trigger all the events in which you already have built. Now, while we actually have this command editor open, they've actually added some new actions specifically for YouTube. So if we go back to our actions list, if we scroll down to the bottom and add a YouTube action, I'm also going to delete these other actions just while we talk about it. So you can see that there is a set title and description, which essentially works the exact same way as the Twitch set title and description. Within Twitch, there is no description, it's just set title. But essentially, you can update the title to whatever you want within your Mixitup. So again, if you've watched our dynamic stream title video, you can use the exact same flows and just swap out that one action with this new YouTube action. And for those of you that haven't watched that video, it's essentially a dynamic stream title. So if anyone, you know, subscribes or, I mean, becomes a member to your channel, you can essentially shout them out within the title, or in this case, also the description. It's a really great way, you know, to, you know, show your appreciation to them. So I'll link that up in the cards over there if you want to have a bit of a sticky beak. But yeah, look, to be honest, there's not much more to talk about. It's going to be a short video, but I mean, the Mixitup team have been working extremely hard to get this integration up and running to the public. And I know they're completely appreciative of the community that have been able and been privileged to be a part of the beta. But if you are new to Mixitup, I have made, like, you know, a get started Mixitup one-on-one video, which I'll link over here. I think these are called tiles or something. I don't really remember off the top of my head. But also put in the description down below for you as well. But if you do have any questions, leave those down there too. But for now, it's been me, Drew, your friendly Mixitup neighborhood ambassador. Stay safe, stay healthy, treat people with kindness, and I'll see you next time.